Beulah Ministries is on. Make a date with Bishop Philip Tago.
Holy words, long preserved.
This and every Saturday, 10:30 to 11 a.m. Faith Well TV on Sky Channel 589 streams live online at faithwellTV.com.
I pray that you will not remain the same after hearing this word. Pray the angel of God to turn life around.
Bishop Philip Tago is also an hour of inspiration every Sunday, 8 to 9 a.m. on Rainbow Radio London. God will minister through his man servant. Your feedback will also be appreciated. Beloved, you will never be forsaken.
God bless you for tuning in. Good morning, and once again, God has allowed us to meet. God has allowed us to come together. God has allowed you and I to have this appointment, even to hear what God has given me to say this morning. It is not by chance that you happen to be watching this program. It is not by chance that you are alive today. Everything happened for a purpose and everything is orchestrated. That is why Bible says that all things work together for good for those that are called by the Lord and according to his purpose. You are watching the program this moment because God wants to hear this word. God has called you to hear this word. Today I want to speak to you about your attitude towards events, your attitude towards people, your attitude towards activities, your attitude towards everything that you do in life. And I want you to stay tuned because God has something greater to share with you today. I'm going to start from Genesis and right through the Bible speak to you about how your attitude determines your blessings. Many of us go through each day and each week and each month and each year doing the same thing over and over and over and wondering and complaining and asking why God hasn't blessed you, why things haven't changed. Well, perhaps today I want you to prepare for your blessing by reviewing your attitude towards things, by reviewing your attitude towards your relationship, by reviewing your attitude towards your job, by reviewing your attitude towards your family, every aspect of your life. I want you to review your attitude. I'm going to read from Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse 1 and 2. And it's a scripture that many of you who go to church, many Christians and many churchgoers, have heard it several times. But I want you to review this word that God gave to Moses again and listen and hear what the Lord is saying. In Genesis 28, verses 1 and 2, it says, "And it shall come to pass, if thou shalt hearken diligently unto the voice of the Lord thy God, to observe to do all his commandments, that which I command thee this day, that the Lord thy God will set thee on high above all nations on this earth. And all these blessings shall come on thee and overtake thee, if thou shalt hearken unto the voice of the Lord." If thou shalt hearken unto the voice of the Lord. It says, "And it shall come to pass, if you will obey diligently the voice of the Lord." In other words, the blessings that God will bring to you is determined, is directly linked about your obedience and your response to the commandments and everything that God is asking you to say. The blessings that will come unto you this year is determined by your attitude and your obedience to the word of God. The blessings that will come to you, the promotion that will come to you this year and this month and this week and this day is directly linked to how you respond to the word of God in your life. And I don't want you to miss your blessings this year. I don't want you to miss the opportunities that God is bringing your way this year. I don't want you to miss the things that God has planned and orchestrated for you this year. For all things will work together for you. But Bible says, it shall come to pass if you will hearken diligently unto the voice of God. It says all these blessings will not only come to you, but will overtake you. The way you respond to things determines what you get out of it. In mathematics and in science, they say input determines output. What you put in determines what you get out. If you value your relationship, then your relationship will be good. If your attitude towards your marriage is brilliant and of respect and high value, then you will get high value back. It's as simple and straightforward as that. And God is saying in Genesis chapter 28, verses 1 and 2, that if you will obey my word and hearken diligently unto my commandment, then these blessings will come unto you. These blessings will overtake you. These blessings will be aligned in your way. Let me tell you something. There are hidden riches out there that God wants you to have. There are blessings out there that God is going ahead of you and making way for you. But that would be determined on how you respond. You see, let me take you to Matthew chapter 13 and read from verse 48. Matthew 13 verse 48. I'll show you a scripture. Jesus Christ was born in Galilee. Jesus Christ came from a certain neighborhood. Jesus Christ lived in that neighborhood. And that neighbor, in that, from 52, it says, and it came to pass when Jesus had finished these parables, he departed thence. And when he was come into his own country, he was come unto his own people. Look at the way they reacted and they responded. Look at the attitude with which they showed to Jesus Christ. And that determined what happened in that place. It says, and it came to pass that when Jesus had finished these parables, and when he was come unto his own country, he taught them in their synagogues, and in so much that they were astonished, and said, whence hath this man got his wisdom and these mighty work? Is not this the carpenter's son? Is not this the man? It's not his mother called Mary. It's not his brothers James and Joseph and Simon and Judas and his sisters. Are they not all with us? When has this man all these things? And they were offended in him. But Jesus said unto them, a prophet is not without honor, save in his own country, in his own house. And the last verse, verse 58, he says, and he did not many mighty miracles there because of their unbelief. Because of the way his own people saw him, because of the attitude towards him, there was no miracle done in his own country. Can you believe that? You see, Jesus Christ had been healing people. He had raised a lady, a child from the dead. He's been curing diseases. He's been touching the lives of other people. And then he came to his own country, and that's no miracles there. Raised no dead in Galilee, lifted no person, healed no leper, did not perform any miracle in his own country. And one will be wondering why. One will be asking why. How come when he goes to other places, they value him and he does all these miracles, but in his own place, nothing happens? How come my husband is good with other people, but when he comes home, he's not good? How come my wife shows respect and everything that she does in other places, everybody admires him, but will not do the same thing at home? I want you to review your attitude towards your relationship. I want you to review your attitude towards Jesus. Because the people in his own country did not see him as a savior. They did not see him as an anointed servant. They did not see him as a called man called of God. They did not see him as someone who has the anointing of God that can break every yoke. Remember when he went to the well and met the woman of Samaria? He said, if you know who you are speaking to, you will give me water to drink. Your attitude towards your head pastor, your attitude towards your man of God, your attitude towards your husband, your attitude towards your boss at work would determine the blessings that you get out of it. Many of you do not value the people in your life. Many of you do not value the job that you even have. Many of you do not value the partner of God God has placed in your life. And because of that, you are finding it hard to receive some blessings. You see, the person that God has chosen to use to bless you, that person you have no respect for. The person that God has selected to use as a vessel of honor to bring miracles into your life, you have no value and respect for that person. How do you expect God to use that person to bring? How do you expect the blessing to come to you? How do you expect the miracle to come to you? Matthew 13, verse 58, it says that Jesus did no miracle in Galilee because of their unbelief. Jesus did no miracle. No miracle. If you want the miracle of God, then you need to change the way you think. You need to change the way you see things. You need to change your attitude. Because that is how the blessing will come to you. Because that is how God will open up the heavens unto you. We read in Genesis 28, it says that, and these things shall come unto you. These blessings shall come unto you. If only you hearken unto the commandments and the word of God. How is your attitude? How is your attitude towards work? You know, one thing which baffles me about some Christians or churchgoers or people in general, they seek a job, they seek the face of God, they fast and pray and God gives them the job. They get a job and then they stop valuing the job. They stop respecting the job. They stop showing the value that is in that place. And then they say, that in my workplace, they are promoting everyone, they are not promoting me. Well, look at your attitude. Look at the way you see the job you are doing. Look at the activities that you are doing. And that will determine your promotion. I don't know who I'm speaking to, but God has sent me to you this morning to even speak into your life, that reveal your attitude, because there is an open heaven upon your life. There is a blessing that is coming to you that will overtake you. Bible says in Deuteronomy 28 verse 2, it says these blessings will come unto you and they will overtake you. I want you to catch these blessings. I want these blessings to stay with you. I don't want it to be to overtake you and bypass you. The hymn writer wrote a song and said, "Pass me not, O gentle Savior. Whilst on others thou art blessing, do not pass me by." I don't want the blessing to pass you by. While God is blessing other people, I want you to review your attitude so that he can pour forth his blessings unto you. God wants to bless you. God is determined to bless you. God wants to pour the shower of blessing upon you. But the moment your attitude is not right. The people of Galilee saw Jesus as an ordinary person, another person. Isn't this Philip Tago, the one that we know? Isn't this Philip, the one that we see? We know his brother, we know his family. And then you expect God to use the same person you are demeaning to bless you. The people of Galilee realized that no miracles were taking place in their life. No, nothing was happening. Jesus, everywhere Jesus went, he was raising the dead. The lepers were being cleansed. The crippled were walking. The blind were seeing. There was an open heaven. People were jubilating because of everything that God was using him to do. And then he comes to his own country and nothing happens. He comes into his own country and no miracle is taking place there. Come on, there must be something wrong somewhere. And the Bible says what was wrong was the people's attitude towards Jesus. Look at how they described him. Isn't this the carpenter's son? Maybe you are seeing a carpenter's son rather than seeing a savior. Maybe you are seeing a carpenter's son in your husband rather than seeing the anointed man that God has given you. Maybe you are seeing the carpenter's daughter rather than seeing the anointed wife that God has given you. You need to change the way you see things. When you appreciate something, it appreciates. I don't know if you understand what I mean by that. When you appreciate and value something, God adds value to it. The more you respect, the more you show different, a positive attitude towards it, the more God opens the blessing upon you. I woke up this morning to bring this word. I said to God, I don't know who will be listening and who will be watching, but I know that at this point in time, you need to hear this word. 2018 has come and gone. In 2019, you are at the same place. God wants you to move forward. God wants you to take a bold step forward, but you can only do it if you change your attitude. Stop saying that it's another day is going to happen again, because it's not going to happen unless you allow it to happen. There are many things in our life that are happening because of our attitude and the way we see it. If you wake up feeling negative, negative will come to you. If you wake up feeling positive, positive will come to you. And I always say, see the best in everything that you do. See the blessed opportunity in everywhere you go. See God at work in every situation. Don't see the negative things that the devil wants you to see. Don't see the negative activity that the devil plays in your way. You see, when something negative happens, the first thing I say is, these two shall pass. That one shall also pass, because God has not created me to experience negativity. Hence, my attitude is always positive. Hence, everything I do is positive. And everywhere I go, I see positive things. I see the best in the people around me. I value the people around me. I see them as precious vessels of honor that God has brought near me to use them to take me to where He wants me to get to. Do you see the people around you that way? If you do not see them that way, then you are wasting your time and you are wasting their time. If you do not see the people, if your attitude towards them, your relationship with people, if your attitude is negative, then you are wasting your time. Because, as I said, the scientists say, output, input determines your output. What you put in, it will determine what will come out. I don't know who I'm speaking to. I don't know who God has sent me to bless this morning. I want you to wake up every day saying, I am determined. I am determined to make sure all things work together for my good, for the good of me, because God has called me. Maybe you are waking up this morning. You have pains all over your body. You've woken up this morning. You have issues going on your mind. You have no peace on your mind. I want you to take a step back. And I want you to say to yourself, God is a God who turns impossible to be possible. Even the word impossible says, I am possible. And so stop it. Stop thinking negatively. Stop showing negative attitude towards situations. And begin. Begin again. Begin afresh. Bible says His mercies are new every morning. So whatever happened yesterday is gone. This day is a new day. And so every morning wake up and say, I am determined to make it better. I am determined to make all things work together for my good. I am determined to make sure the blessings that God has stated in Genesis 28 will come to me. And I want to read that Genesis 28. Some of the blessings that God has said will come to you. Remember in verse 2, it says, if you will have a positive attitude and obey, then these blessings will not only come to you, but will overtake you. Are you ready for the blessings to overtake you? Are you ready for the blessings to come to you? It says, you will be blessed. You will be blessed in the city where you dwell, and you will be blessed in the field. I don't know where you are dwelling at the moment. I don't know the city in which you are. The Bible says in verse 3 that you will be blessed there. Wherever you find yourself, you will be blessed there. You don't have to travel far and wide. God is going to bless you where you are now. Maybe you are thinking, I don't know who I'm speaking to, maybe you are thinking that where you are now is not where you are supposed to be. Let me tell you, before God takes you to where you are supposed to be, even where you are now, you ought to be blessed. You ought to be blessed where you are now. He says, blessed are you in the city where you dwell, and blessed are you in the field. Wherever you are finding yourself this morning, whatever you are finding yourself doing, whichever way you want to say it, I want you to see it as positive, and God will use it to bless you. There are people in your life, in that city where you are dwelling. There are the vessels of honor in your life. Nobody hates you. Nobody, I always say it, nobody hates you, depending on the way you see them. And even if they do, their wishes are not horses. What they think of is not what God determines. Bible says, who is he that saith, and it cometh to pass, when God has not spoken. So whatever any negative word has been spoken into your life, it will not come to pass unless God sanctions it. And God will not sanction negativity in your life. He says you'll be blessed. You will be blessed. You will be blessed 2019. You will be blessed. In my church, we have 2019 as a year of supernatural visitation. In other words, God is going to visit us this year. Are you ready for that visitation? We are, and we have a positive attitude to it. We are ready to receive the visitation of God. And I believe that God is going to visit you in your home. God is going to visit you at your workplace. God is going to visit you at your church, wherever you find yourself. Because Deuteronomy 28, verse 3, it says, blessed are you in the city where you dwell. So God is going to bless you. And I speak this morning as a servant of God who has never failed me. God has never failed me. He is not about to fail me because I serve a God of success. I serve a God of victory. I serve a God who heals my pain. I serve a God who brings peace unto me. I serve a God whose word says that a peace which passes all understanding. And so every day I wake up cheerfully. I wake up very happy because I know with their positive attitude, God is going to bless me. I know with a positive attitude, there is an open heaven coming unto me. And I pray in the name of Jesus, wherever you are, I want you to put your hand over your chest and pray and say, God, pour forth your anointing over me from the crown of my head to the soles of my feet. I want you to pray that prayer, that anointing will come over you and break every yoke and every chain in your life, so that after this sermon, after this session, after this program, you will walk around everywhere you go knowing that God has blessed you, knowing that there is an open heaven. I pray in the name of Jesus, wherever you are. I pray in the name of Jesus, whether you are home, whether you are at work, whether you are in the city. I pray that the hand of God will lead you beside the still waters. I pray that blessings will come upon you. If you are feeling pain, I pray that the peace which passes all understanding will touch you even as I speak. Put your hand wherever the pain is and say in the name of Jesus, say in the name of Jesus, Lord, touch it and relieve me of that pain. And that pain will go. Remember the centurion. I'm going to tell you about the centurion. The centurion went to Jesus and said, my daughter is at home and is not well. But the centurion had a very positive attitude. He said, Jesus, you don't need to come to my house. I am a centurion. I am the one who God has called and has commanded an army of 100. I said to them, let them stand and they will stand. I said to them, let them sit and they will sit. I am a commander in chief of them. And what I say, they do it. You don't need to come to my house. Jesus said, because of your attitude, because of your faith, your daughter has been made whole. Maybe you are watching me today, this morning. Your attitude will determine the blessing. Your attitude will determine the healing that you deserve. Your attitude will determine the open heaven that God has placed over your life. I want you to know that God is up to something. God is up to something in your life to bring a miracle unto you. In the name of Jesus, I want you to receive that miracle. In the name of Jesus, I want you to place your hand over your head and say, from this day forward, my promotion is coming and I receive it. In the name of Jesus, I say every negativity out of my life. And I ask that I will value those that God will send unto me. I ask, oh God, that you value whoever he sends unto your life. Maybe you are complaining about your marriage. Maybe you are complaining about your job. Maybe you are complaining about your social circle and nothing is working for you. I want you to change your attitude. I want you to change how you view things. I want you to change how things are happening around you. For there is an open heaven there, and I want you to tap onto it. Silver and gold have I none, all I have is Jesus. Silver and gold have I none, all I have is Jehovah Jireh. Silver and gold have I none, all I have is the King of Kings, and he is here to bless you. But I pray that you change your attitude. I don't know what it is that is stopping you. I don't know what it is that is hindering you. But review yourself, review your character, review your way you talk, review your way you do things. And God will bless you. It's as simple and straightforward. He says all these blessings will come to you. He says, blessed shall thou be, in verse 6 of Deuteronomy 28, blessed shall thou be when thou comest in, and blessed shall thou be when you go out. In your coming in and your going out, God will bless you. I'm sure today God has used me to bring the blessing unto you. Remember, my church is Beulah Ministries worldwide, and we meet at All Saints. All Saints Church at New Cross. New Cross, SE14, from 4 p.m. to 5:30, where we receive the miracle and the word of God. Join us every Sunday at that place, and you'll be happy you did. Change your attitude, and God will bless you. Change the way you value things, and God will increase them. Change and appreciate the relationship you have, and you'll be happier. Change the way you talk to people, and you will notice that they will give you the attention that you require. It's all in the attitude. It's all in the attitude that you have. And I know there is an open heaven over your life. God is about to do something great for you. God is about to send you to places, higher heights and higher places. Know that the time has come, and that time is now. Change your attitude and receive your blessings, because this is the day the Lord has made. You can get in touch with me on 0793925841, 0793925841. And every Saturday from 10:30 a.m. to 11 a.m., save it. Make it an appointment and have it as a date. And every Saturday, you hear the word of God coming from me live from the studios of Faith World TV. Remain blessed this day. Remain blessed and know that your attitude will determine your blessing. Your attitude will determine how far God will take you. Your attitude will determine your altitude, as some will say, because there is an open heaven in your life. In Jesus' name.
Beulah Ministries is on. Make a date with Bishop Philip Tago.
Holy words, long preserved.
This and every Saturday, 10:30 to 11 a.m. Faith World TV on Sky Channel 589. Streams live online at faithworldtv.com.
I pray that you will not remain the same after hearing this word. Pray the angel of God to turn life around.
Bishop Philip Tago is also an hour of inspiration every Sunday, 8 to 9 a.m. on Rainbow Radio London. God will minister through his manservant. Your feedback will also be appreciated. Beloved, you will never be forsaken.
God bless you for tuning in.
Changing me and changing